It's time for the Family Feud, introducing the Bass family. Carol, Terry, Cheryl, Karen, and Mike, ready for action. And the Ohde family, Carolyn, James, Martha, Jessica, and Donna. On your mark, let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Sammy Davis Jr.
For Richard, but I'm very happy and thrilled and honored and embarrassed. But Richard Dawson has been a friend of mine for many, many years. And when I first went to London, we had the good fortune of becoming friends, and it has remained. I am probably the first fan of the show that he does, and I love him as a human being. I love him for what he does on the stage. And all of the crew, the producer, the director, and everybody was nice enough to say, why don't you go out and do this? And Richard, of course, said so. But this spot belongs to the one man who is the best at doing it than anybody I know. Ladies and gentlemen, my pleasure to introduce Mr. Richard Dawson.
Thank you. How you doing? It's beautiful, huh? Mr. Wonderful! Hello! Camera! Without you, I'm nothing. You're beautiful. He's beautiful. Let me tell you.
Sam and his whole family, Alto and everybody, they've watched this show. I think with the exception, like, Bob Goulet is the other absolute freak who will call me three times a week, as you will. He'll call me and say, what was there with that family today, or that question? He loves this show, and he spoke to me yesterday. I said, please come down and say hello, and he did. Now I'm going to ask you something that you don't know. First of all, Steve Lawrence at the dinner the other night said, I want to get on with Edie and my family to play for charity, a saloon act.
Yes.
I said, I bet you Sammy and his family would come on, because I know they love this game. They love to play it. And Steve said, Sammy, what are you kidding? We just knock them off like that. That's more or less... A gauntlet was thrown down.
Well, let me tell you something.
Yeah.
Now, Steve Lawrence is Mr. Good Singer.
Right.
His wife is adorable. And we're dear friends.
Right.
You know, and we did the Academy Award together on this network.
I know you did.
Okay. Now, I'm only going to tell you one thing. I will cut him nine ways Sunday.
And do you accept the challenge?
I accept the challenge.
What we got to do. Right. We've got to do a nighttime, one-hour special, nighttime, with Sammy and his family versus the Steve Lawrence family. They'll play for charity. And right now, although they're my friends, I'm going to bet on Sam.
Yeah, man.
I
got to tell you one thing that I'm going
to
split, because I know you're going
to
play.
No,
no,
I
want
to do.
Okay, but I just want to tell you, when I was in the hospital about 9 months ago,
right,
I bought Family Feud.
Oh, the game?
The game.
Yeah.
And I played it.
Did you play me?
No. My secretary played you. Margaret Ware played you. And if we're in the hospital at Cedars-Sinai, this is the truth, I'm getting examined, and people are going, what's going on in there? Because they're going, ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. And there was 20 people in my room. But I'm going to tell you, we won that time. We will win when we come back. You just pick the date. We will be here.
You got to do it.
And we'll pick the
charity. Can I give you a surprise?
Yes.
Play the first question. You know this game backwards. Do it. First question, they're the champs right there.
They're the champs?
You take this, yeah. That's how much they've won.
This is the Bath family, and you've won a Let me see if I can get that marvelous sort of savoir-faire that Richard has. Up to this point, you've won $5,476. Right? Right. And everybody's going to be here. We've got... Now, tell me, who have you brought with you?
I'm Carol, and I'm so proud to meet you. That was quite a shock, but it was a real thrill.
Thank you.
This is my youngest daughter, Terry.
Hello, Terry.
My oldest daughter, Cheryl.
Hello, Cheryl.
My dear daughter-in-law, Karen.
Hello, Karen.
And my oldest son, Michael.
Michael.
Hello.
Another tall guy. Mom. Now, here's the people that's going to try to beat you.
Ohde.
The ODs.
Yeah.
He does. Yeah.
Thank you. Now, Carolyn, tell me, I hear that you're from Scotland?
That's right. Yes, we're from Scotland. I've been here about 8 years.
Yes.
And this is my brother-in-law, James.
Yes.
And my sister, his wife, Martha.
Hello, Martha.
My sister, Jessica.
Hello.
And her daughter, Donna.
Hello. Now, let me ask you something. If you've been here 8 years, why do you still have that brogue?
I'll always have that, I think.
Do you think you will?
I think I will.
Well, then, let's give it a shot anyway.
Okay.
Let's play the Feud! Nobody told me which file do I take it from.
First one. Top one.
This one here like this?
Yeah.
Or is it the yellow one? There's a yellow one here.
No, the yellow one's the big one.
Oh. That's it?
Yeah.
This is worse than marching in Mississippi during the Civil War. Now, top five answers are on the board. Try to find the most popular answer. Now, listen to the question. Name a kind of product that advertises itself as mild.
Cigarette.
Cigarette. Let's see if it's there. There is one answer better than that. Would you like to see it?
Sure. Soap.
Soap. All right. That's a very good answer.
Thank you.
I use it every day.
Oh, so
I'm trying to do what he does. I'm going right into the toilet. Soap. You're going
to
pass.
Yes.
All right, you go back there, darling. You've got it.
Oh, my.
All right. Now I take the mic and I go over here.
Right, going so smoothly. I'm so proud of you.
Thank you very much.
I'm in rehearsal with Mr. Wonderful.
Name a kind of a product. Excuse me. Yes, it's your turn.
Oh.
Go. Name a kind of a product that advertises itself as mild.
Liquor.
Good answer, Carol. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay. Can we say that on the air as such? Good. Okay, then. Here we go. Liquor. I find it mild all the time. I say that. Name a kind of a product that advertises itself as mild.
Shampoo.
Uh-huh. Yay! All right, we'll see. That's a very good answer. We'll see if it's up there, okay? Shampoo! Hello! Already. He's got
he knows it, yeah.
Oh. Name a kind of a product that advertises itself as mild.
Cleansers.
That is the same as soap, and I'll give you another chance.
Okay, how about lotion?
Lotion. Take a shot, you know.
Okay.
What can you do? Lotion!
Second
two strikes. You got one more strike left, and then, you know, the ODs get a chance to steal things. Okay. Now, Mike, look at me good, babe. I'm not going to kiss him. The last guy I hugged and kissed lost the presidency. Firm handshake is all they gonna get. Name a kind explain of a product that advertises itself as mild?
Cosmetics.
That's a good one.
Yeah. Good? Well, let's try it and see it, but it's a good try, Mike. Cosmetics!
Over.
Okay, here we go now. Are we finished praying? Or are you blowing up a bagpipe here? What are you doing?
Cheese. We're going to try cheese.
All right. Very good idea. Cheese!
Reveal.
All right. Number five.
Yeah, he's got it.
Which is, we'll be right back with your regular host right after this commercial.
You're one. Do not adjust your sets. I've not gotten paler. It's me. I'm back. $91 there. Nothing there. Let's go. Kind of a special day, though. Wasn't that fun to be here?
Yeah.
All right. 100 people surveyed. Top 6 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something people do once a year.
Yeah. Buy a new car.
Buy a new car? Let's say, Jane.
Go to church at Christmas.
Just once a year. A little church. Not there. Cheryl, darling.
Come on, Cheryl.
Something people do once a year.
Celebrate Christmas.
Celebrate Christmas?
Celebrate a birthday?
A little birthday.
All right.
What are you going to do?
You'll pass, Richard.
You pass everything. Go over there. I'm absolutely surprised at them. Hi, Don. How are you?
Hello. Hi.
Something people do once a year.
Watch the ball games on New Year's Day.
Okay.
Good.
The ball game! First try. How you doing, Mike? What do you think? Something people do once
pay
a year.
Pay their taxes.
Looking for the tax man.
Come on.
Number one. What do you think?
I can't think of a thing.
You've got 3 seconds.
Oh. Do once a year.
Yeah. Second factor.
Take a vacation.
Aha. Vacation, yeah. There, you're all right. If not, third strike, vacation. You're right there. Well, I'm not letting Sam get me out of those kisses. What do you think? 3 seconds, something people do once a year. There's a chance for you to steal. Come on, Miss Sweetheart, something you get there. They love it if you say it.
Well, celebrate Thanksgiving.
Answer is?
Celebrate New Year.
All right, have a happy New Year. All right, if it's there, you get $62, big lead. If not, you're in this game. New Year! We'll be back right after you. Challenges have the money. 153, nothing there. Come on, Angel. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top 5 answers on the board. The question is, name something people borrow from their co-workers at work.
Yeah. Money.
Money! Number one. What are you going to do?
Play.
They're going to play. Well, you probably knew that. Yeah, something people borrow from their co-workers at work.
Pencil.
I borrow a pencil.
Good.
What do you think? 3 seconds.
Newspaper.
Newspaper! Yeah. Not there. First try. Yeah.
Paper.
They borrow paper.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Just paper. No, not there. Something people borrow from their co-workers at work. 2 strikes.
How about their typewriter?
Okay. If that's there, you're all right. If not, third strike. Typewriter? Not there. Oh, there's enough money up there to make you the champs. What do you say?
Two.
Is it two, Richard?
Two. All righty. Tools there, you're the new champs. If not, you're in this game. Do they borrow two? Money there, Angel, but you've got $5,476. What are you giving me this for? Tell me about the baby. That's what it's going to be for. Who's going to play? Let's go. Who's first? Good girl. Go to your room. Carolyn's going for the money right after we watch this.
Thank you very much, Gene. You ready?
I'm ready.
What part of Scotland are you from?
Motherwell.
Motherwell?
Mm-hmm. You know where that is?
Certainly I do. Sure. In Ireland.
Oh. I was hoping you weren't going to say that, Richard.
Where is it?
It's 12 miles from Glasgow.
Yeah, I know it's around that area. Mm-hmm. Very pretty, though. Glasgow's not pretty, but Motherwell's
not. Motherwell's very pretty.
I'm glad your mother is well. Give me 15 seconds, please.
A little kiss for luck.
Thank you.
Be quiet over there immediately.
Yeah, shut up, Martha.
They're all over there juicing it up, you know.
Name a sport a small person can be as good at as a big person.
Baseball.
A measurement of time.
Minute.
Something in the kitchen you polish.
Bridge.
A toy kids have in a sandbox.
A truck.
A prize won in raffles.
A car.
Turn around. You're very good. Yeah, a sport, a small person can be as good as a big person. You said baseball. A survey said 21. Measurement of time. You said
just a minute.
A survey said 19. You got 40. Something in the kitchen you polish. You said the fridge. Always polish your fridge.
I do.
Right. Clean fridge. Green. Survey said 8. A toy the kids have in a sandbox. You said truck. A survey said 3. And a prize won in raffles. You said car. Survey said. You got 81. Clear the board. That's good. You go back there. Now we're looking for Bonnie Jane. Come on, Jane. How you doing?
Well?
No.
No? You're fine, aren't you?
Kind of shaky.
Nothing to be shaky about here. Open fire. What music were they playing in there on the earphone?
I don't know.
Good.
Brainwashing.
Probably then Glenn Campbell. Well, I'm going to ask the same questions I asked the sister-in-law. You cannot duplicate her answers. If you do, you get this. I'll say try again. You give me another answer. Okay, champ?
Okay.
Well, please remind everyone the answers Carolyn give us. Give me 20 seconds on the clock, please. Name a sport a small person could be as good at as a big person.
Baseball.
Try again.
Soccer.
A measurement of time.
Hours.
Something in the kitchen that you polish.
Silverware.
A toy kids have in a sandbox.
Ring.
A prize won in raffles.
Car.
Try again. What was your answer for the sandbox one?
A ring.
A ring.
Rubber ring.
Oh, rubber ring. RR. Rubber ring. All right. What sort of sport? Small person. Good as a big person. You said? Soccer, our survey said? 7. Baseball, number 1. You got 88. Measurement of time we asked. You said an hour. That was the number 1 answer our survey said. 45. You got 133. Something in the kitchen that you polish. You said silverware. That was the number 1 answer. Survey said 47. You got 108. A toy kids have in the sandbox. You said the dreaded and testy rubber ring. Survey said 0. They have a shovel in a sandbox. And then a prize won in raffles. You duplicated the answer, ran out of time. Car was number 1.
You got 180, though. $5 for every point you got a total of. There's $900, okay? We'll be back right after this. Well, you've got enough money to buy several rubber rings. You've got $1,201. You're the champ. You'll play again next time we get together here on the field. We love you.
Some departing contestants receive Fabergé's Farrah Fawcett hair care product.
This was the original version of the game show Russian Roulette.
Spin the wheel, only 5 rubles. Grand prize, loaf of bread, only 4 days old.
It needed some tinkering.
Let's play Russian Roulette. Yeah! Watch your step.
You only live once. Let's go for it.
The vastly improved Russian Roulette tonight at 11 p.m. Eastern and Pacific, only on Game Show Network.
Why? This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.